Hello, welcome to another session of MapInfo, where I will show you how you can plot the measurements taken from the field for structures. So I usually, when I record the structure readings, I usually use the Excel spreadsheet, and the Excel spreadsheet should look like this. It must have easting, northing, and elevation to show the position of where your reading was taken from, and you must have the strike, the angle of dip, and the dip direction. You must have also the structure type and the discover code. The discover code in MapInfo doesn't, MapInfo Discover does not recognize if you write foliation. It doesn't recognize it. Therefore, you have to put a code that will tell the software that the structure that I'm referring to is a foliation. Therefore, every structure has a different code. For example, foliation foliation has a code of 17, and for example, joints, you see there's 16, and if there's any other structures, then they have different codes. To get these codes, you just come to MapInfo and then go discover. Then you will come to discover help, discover help. On discover help, search for structure codes. Just search for structure codes and click enter. You see discover structure codes, click there. You see all the codes for different structures that someone can measure from the mapping exercise. And these are the codes. For example, the thrust fault is 31. See fault gauge and range, everything. Every structure that someone can measure is here, and these are the codes. So I'll close out of this one, so this is the spreadsheet. I'll also close out of this one. Therefore, to plot this structure data in MapInfo, what you do, you just come to file, open, as long as you know where you have saved your file. And for example, for mine is an Excel file, and I know where it is. I'll just select file of type is Excel, and structure data. I normally create a copy in MapInfo to read lighting, just in case if I want to do any changes. Then you click open. In here, on a name range, select work structure data. And use rows above selected range for column titles, and click OK. Now you have got your data now in a MapInfo format, which is a tab file. Then you can come to table, create points, choose your projection. For example, for mine is mine is Universal Transverse Mercator Zone 36 South, and then I'll click OK. You can also choose here the symbol that you want to use, and then click OK. Click OK. Close out of this one, and to view your data, just come and say new map window. You see, there you go. Those are your measurements, but you see they just have appeared like points. Therefore, to plot them so that they appear as structures, you come to discover, then say structure symbols. there's data input by processed from a table, digitized into mapper, digitized into a new table. I'll say process from a table because I have a table which has the data and the structured data, and then click OK. Then specify azimuth as deep direction, because our spreadsheet had all options of strike and the deep. You can use specify azimuth as strike using the right hand rule, or specify azimuth as deep direction. I'll use this one because I have the data in this format as well. I can use this one because I have the strike as well, but I'll use this one. Therefore, from easting, I'll just say easting. From nothing, I'll say nothing. And deep direction is deep direction, deep angle, and the structure code, I'll put discover code. You can select the symbol that you want. I'll just leave that one, and then deep and the plunges mapping for labels, and just click OK. You see, everything is now there. Everything. Easy like that. So if you like this video, please share it, put a comment, and click like. Thank you for watching, and don't miss my other sessions.